Yo, what's happening everyone? It's your boy here, Abdulrahim, back again with another great amazing tech video. Well, the video today is all about tutorials, and on this kind of tutorial is just that we're having After Effects. I didn't cover it, and I told you guys that I'm gonna cover Adobe After Effects. And sorry guys to say this, but not only sorry, but my condolences to what happened yesterday. It was crazy, but my condolences. I got nothing much to say. It's so sad. So for further info, let us just get started with this tutorial of today. So yeah, we're inside After Effects, and the main thing is just that we're gonna click create new composition. So in our composition, you can see it's motion graphics, then you can add like lower thirds, so lower thirds and titles. So I'm gonna click OK. After having that, we're gonna just go all the way here and create our new text. Our text is gonna be perhaps welcome or Abdulrahim 112, or even your name or anything. You can just name it there. Now pay close attention here. Whenever I move a subject and caps lock is on, you're gonna get this error. Don't worry, just press caps lock, release caps lock, and you can see everything is back to normal. So whenever you get that error, just release caps locks. Don't shut off your software or don't turn it off. Now we are having this anchor point here. You're gonna click Y on the keyboard and move our anchor point up to on the middle, because if we leave it here, what will happen is just that whenever we do adjustment, it's gonna appear on this bottom here. But right now, since we made our anchor point at the center, all the changes is gonna be at the center. Now if I reverse, so as to show you how what's gonna happen, is just that if I go back to transform and I scale it, you can see it's starting from there. But if I just click Y on the keyboard and move our anchor point up to on the center somewhere here, if I scale it, you're gonna see it starting at the center. That's what we want. Now after that, we're gonna just make our text here or here at the center or anywhere. First of all, for animating it, now we're gonna just do this way. First of all, there's something called keyframe. You must pay close attention to keyframe, since keyframe, they play big role on After Effects. Now you can see if I change a position going this way, now I want my position to be somewhere here. Now I'm gonna go first of all 5 keyframes. So I'm gonna click on the position, then I'm gonna go back to my position, then I'm gonna just do this way, go all the way here. Now I'm gonna bring it up to here, my keyframe somewhere there. So I want it to come all the way here at the center. So if I release it and press spacebar, you can see it's coming up there. But all I want is I want to go back again to 5 keyframes. Then I want to change the click keyframe of opacity, then go back here again and release opacity up to down. So if I go back here, you can see it's coming up. So if I play, you can see it's delaying, but it's coming up. That's a layer, not layer, but that's a keyframe. Sorry guys, that's a keyframe adjustment. So I'm gonna adjust my keyframe. So I'm gonna click these 2 keyframes and bring all the way forward up to there. So after that, I'm gonna press play or press space bar for playing. You can check it out how it flows, but I want it to flow in a good way. Now I'm gonna release it up here. Now there's a magic work comes, it's called the smooth. Now the smooth is quite great, since the smooth gives you those kind of animation which are so smooth. Now I press control and click on the keyframe, you can see our keyframe is rounded. Now click here, you can see our keyframe is rounded. Now I want that kind of rounded, since I want it to be more smooth. It's like the type of easy ease, as you can see how it goes, boom, just like that. We have created our first lower third. Now inside our lower third, you can see there's nothing else, it's just a text. Now if I want to make like a subject, like a square popping up or coming up and down, I can just do it there. It's just quite simple. Now all I can do is just right click it on new here on our lower panel, and we're gonna just click shape layer, and we're gonna create our first or our second, or here somewhere here down, I think it's gonna click a lot, so bring it somewhere there. So on this side, you can see our shape layer is selected. Now we have our shape layer somewhere here. Now we're gonna add something called trim path. Now we need trim path because trim path gonna give us something like an offset, something like this. We want something like this to be animated. So we'll bring the end up to zero. Then we're gonna check it out. It's starting here. Then when it comes here, I want it when it reaches here, I want the keyframe to start there and another one to start. Now I don't need this offset, leave the offset as it is. So I'm gonna just go again two keyframes forward, or I'm gonna return these two keyframes at the back a little bit. I know it's a little bit confusing, but you have just to pay close attention and get it. So on this side, I'm gonna just do this way. I'm gonna increase that keyframe bar all the way up to here. Now if we reverse it back, now this is how it's gonna happen. You can see it's very fast, right? Now we need these two keyframes to return them at the back a little bit. So we need something like this, a little bit smooth. Wow, that looks good. So this is our subject, but I'm gonna increase our subject. Now increase it up to somewhere here. I'm gonna just do this way. I'm gonna bring it somewhere here, and I'm gonna change the stroke size a little bit. Now I changed my mind. I just wanted to make something there, but I thought that why should I not just make it on this text, so as we can save some time. So on this side, we're gonna increase it a little bit up to there. So if I just do this way, just check it out. You can see, that's how our lower third right now. We created our first lower third. It's called lower third. Sometimes I just like rules of third, but it's called lower third. So just like that, we've made our first lower third. So I hope some of you guys got it ASAP, since I don't want to take a bunch of time on this kind of lower third. I hope you're gonna just get creative and play around with this kind of stuff. I know this is just like a first lower third. I know some of you guys, you might be like, this kind of stuff is so complicated and this is just a demo. Well, on this kind of demo, it's just that you're getting those kind of brief whereby they're gonna push you or help you out throughout the guideline of After Effects. So I hope some of you guys enjoyed on this kind of tutorial, and thank you guys for watching, and I'm going to catch you guys on the next one. As always, stay sharp and creative, and peace.